annual report on the state of human rights and freedom by the Uganda Human Rights Commission states that the mushrooming Pentecostal churches, which have increased in the past 20 years, lack a proper structure.
The commission monitored what was happening in the country, and our findings were that there's a lot of misinformation, there's extortion and corruption. And this is not done by one sect, but it is more prominent in the Pentecostal churches because they do not have structures that govern them, where the reporting hierarchies are lacking.
The report indicates that the absence of clear regulations for Pentecostal churches has provided a window for pastors, apostles, and prophets to abuse the faith.
See that the Pentecostal church is building, or the section is really growing at a very fast rate, but because there are no guidelines, there is no legislative or policy framework, everyone does what they please. And because of that, there have been unscrupulous people who are hiding in the name of religion or in the name of establishing Pentecostal churches, and they are exploiting people.
Ruth Sechindi, the director in charge of monitoring and inspections at the commission, says although the constitution prohibits religious discrimination, there is a lot of misinformation in churches which puts believers in a vulnerable position. The commission now wants the government to put in place clear rules and procedures that regulate establishment of places of worship and their operations, and empower citizens from falling prey.
I've seen issues or instances where women and girls have been raped or defiled. We have seen instances of a financial extortion where they have taken their properties and their finances. There is lack of accountability. And we have also seen that in other sects such as Islam, the Muslim leaders reported instances of Islamophobia. That Islamophobia is the hatred for Muslims.
The Uganda Human Rights Commission has registered a 20% increase in the number of complaints. 4,370 complaints were registered in 2022 compared to 3,624 that were recorded in 2021. More cases registered have to do with violations of human rights in areas of environment, famine, fuel prices, Ebola outbreak, among others.
The reporting period, we received 4,370 complaints, out of which 691 were registered as complaints raising alleged human rights violations as guided by our admissibility criteria. The complaints received represented all the matters reported to us, whether admissible or not. There was a 20% increase in the complaints received from 3,624 complaints that were received in 2021.
They attribute increased case reporting to the introduction of a mobile van which traverses the country. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.